Let's go, the best French teacher on the low. Learn French, learn today. Learn for free, learn your way. Learn French with Vincent, let's go. The best French teacher on the low. Learning French is simple and free. Learn French with Vincent, A to Z. Easy, fun, 1, 2, 3. Subscribe to the channel to support me. Students all around the world learning fast. Young to old, I am the best. Learning French is simple and free. Learn French with Vincent, A to Z. Learn French with Vincent today. Bonjour à tous, j'espère que vous allez bien. C'était un petit peu sportif le début. Je suis un petit peu malade, je crois. So I'm just a little bit sick. I don't know what's happening. I was with the mask and everything. And I hope I didn't catch any terrible things, but we'll see. So if it cuts, it's just because I will be good for today. But I think everything will be okay. So let's take the time to say hello to everybody. Bonjour Omar, vous Slat est avec nous. Yasmine et la Victoria Jacques est là, bien sûr. Yossi, bonjour. Bonjour. Romand est là aussi. Bonsoir. Qui est-ce qu'il y a d'autre? Je regarde. Alors, attendez, Maria Bethania est là, Hilary Orwell est là aussi, Cosmina Bellou est là aussi, Olga Ruiz est là, alors je regarde, Cheryline nous rejoint, bonjour, bonne nuit Cheryline, Sylvia Dama est avec nous, Ganitacho, ok, so I guess we can start, and Gérard is with us, and you can see that, of course, Gérard is not alone, Gérard is not alone, and it will be, of course, at one point something that we will have to decide together, the name of the wife of Gérard. So Gérard has a wife now, as you can see. She's extremely beautiful, and she's got... elle a les tresses comme ça. Voilà, Cloudy Sky nous rejoint. J'espère que vous allez bien. So remember, stay inside if you want, because when I went to get Gérard's wife, I might have caught something that I was not supposed to catch, but it's okay. We'll see. Merci beaucoup. On y va. Alors, let's start. Before we start, as you know, each time I've got to say that because I think it's quite good. If it's the first time with this stream or with these exercises, remember to open a tab. And then in this tab, you will, open a dictionary. It will be much more efficient if you can use the dictionary. And if you encounter some names or some words, sorry, nouns, words, or then verbs that you don't understand, then use the dictionary. It will be much more efficient and fast, and after that you can have a list of the new words that you've been discovering during this lesson. D'accord? So we've been coming up with these ones: wordreference.com, deeple.com, collinsdictionary.com, larousse.fr, then Google Translate. It is up to you, but open that and you will see that it will be much more efficient. Allez, on y va. And of course, don't forget to click on the like. It's your way of saying merci beaucoup, Vincent, for the exercises, and it will please me. Merci. So don't forget to click on like. Allez, the question of the day is: une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme, and then you can continue the sentence. Obviously, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme. Mercurial, Vincent est en retard. Yeah, but I'm sick. I'm sick. It was whether I was late or that I was not coming. I'm sorry. Allez-y. « Alors, Evelina nous rejoint. Bonjour, bonjour. Cosmina propose déjà le nom de la femme de Gérard. Ce sera pour tout à l'heure. Il y a une petite rubrique, bien sûr, pour proposer le nom de la femme de Gérard. Alors, Emma nous rejoint. Bonjour, bonjour, Emma. Alors, attention, on attaque, Barat nous rejoint aussi. Bonsoir, bonjour, Barat. Vouslat nous dit, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme le paradis. Apparemment, Vouslat déteste le mardi. Pourquoi, Vouslat? C'est bizarre, non? Est-ce que le mardi, c'est un jour terrible, peut-être? Alors, Bickert nous dit, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme un papillon avec une aile, peut-être cassée. Paola qui nous dit, le système scolaire sans la planète Mars. Ah, ça me rappelle des choses intéressantes. Cosmina Bellouf, alors, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme une semaine, c'est comme le système digestif sans l'œsophage. Vous avez des drôles d'idées en ce moment. Julia, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme une semaine dont le vendredi va arriver plus tôt. Oh, la logique imparable de Julia. Olga, d'accord. Ah non, non, non. Olga, on ne parle pas des noms encore. Pas tout de suite les noms. Pas tout de suite. Yasmine, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme un chemin rapide vers le week-end, c'est vrai. Barat, 6 jours dans la semaine. Oui. Barat, c'est compté. Yossi, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme un jour sans soleil. Donc vous aimez bien le mardi, Yossi. Mercurial qui nous dit, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme une année sans juillet. Très bien. Package, bonsoir, bonjour. Très bien. Je vais très bien, Package Catri. Participez au cours. You can join the lesson. So try to continue the sentence. Une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme. Ali, Omar, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme une semaine de vacances plus courte. Très bien. Romande, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme si on a oublié quelque chose. C'est vrai. Victoria Jacques, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme une semaine sans deuxième lundi. Pourquoi? Est-ce que vous êtes fatigué, Victoria Jacques? Est-ce que vous êtes fatigué encore? Paul, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme une nuit sans lune. Ça, c'est pas mal. C'est vrai que la nuit sans la lune, on la cherche. Et pourtant, il y en a beaucoup. Cloudy Sky, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme un bonheur, car c'est un jour pour le travail. D'accord, très bien. Hilary, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme une semaine plus courte. Oui. Cheryline, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme une oasis de productivité, parce qu'il n'y a pas de réunion inutile. Oui, mais l'avantage, Cheryline, c'est que j'imagine que pour vous, c'est pareil. Non, à l'université, les réunions sont dématérialisés, sont virtuels, donc on peut faire autre chose. YouTube Browser, bonjour, bonjour. Et Victoria qui nous dit qu'elle est fatiguée. Allez, à vous la parole, Guitou qui nous rejoint, et puis Katil Geek, bonjour, bonjour, bonjour. You can participate to the lesson, it will be in English and in French, but all the exercises will be, of course, in French. À vous la parole, quels sont les deux mots qui vous décrivent le mieux? Bonjour Fiona, bonjour, bonjour. Quels sont les deux mots qui vous décrivent le mieux? Allez-y. Kirill, une semaine sans mardi, c'est comme une fièvre sans Doliprane. Il faudrait que je prenne du Doliprane. Tiens, merci. Merci, Kirill, merci. Alors, c'est Vouslat qui commence. Vouslat nous dit « travailleuse et rieuse ». Mariam qui nous dit « drôle et gentille ». Emma qui nous dit « fou et amusant ». D'accord, très bien, amusant, A-N-T. Yulia qui nous dit « fou et obsessionnel ». À des choses très fraîches et joyeuses. Cosmina qui nous dit ambitieuse et gentille. Gayatri Roubert qui nous dit bonjour, 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 participez. So you can participate to the lesson. You have to give me two words that could describe you. Deux mots qui peuvent vous décrire le mieux. Mercurial qui nous dit sur le point, ça fait trois mots. Hilary qui nous dit vieille et drôle. D'accord. Yasmine. Alors, normal et amateur de chocolat. Très bien. Paul Joshua qui nous dit réservé et travailleur. Roman qui nous dit ambitieux et parlant, communicatif. Sylvia qui nous dit chic et content. Très bien. Ben qui nous dit je sais parler français, qu'est-ce que je fais ici? Je n'en ai aucune idée. C'est une très bonne question, Ben. Mais restez là puisque l'ambiance est bonne. Paola qui nous dit utopique et tranquille. Et Ben, vous pouvez nous dire deux mots qui pourraient vous définir, qui pourrait vous décrire, ça pourrait être sympathique, Ben. Gayatri, moi et mon travail, ok. Bickert, la discipline et patience ou patiente. Cloudy Sky, assouplissement, vigueur. C'est pas mal, ça, comme... c'est intéressant, hein, un mélange intéressant. Evelina qui nous dit vif et extraverti, pardon. Omar, ponctuel, et ça, c'est très bien, excusez-moi pour aujourd'hui, mais là, c'est la maladie, hein, et coopératif. Fiona Adams, gentille et contente, ça, c'est très bien. Cause it's here, bonsoir, bonjour Vincent, heureux et motivé, ça c'est très très bien. H.J. Lee, prisonnier, ou non prisonnier, ça c'est moi, passionnée et positive. Victoria Jacques, alors heureuse et aventureuse, je dirais même amateur de vin, mais ça fait trois mots, c'est vrai, vous n'avez pas le droit. Barat, alors amusant et stylé. Huang, jolie et douce. Yossi, pédant et ambitieux. Ah, pédant, c'est direct, hein, c'est direct. Cheryline, déterminée, mais timide. YouTube Browser, parente, bon sens de l'humour. Hung qui nous dit boulot et dodo. Et vous n'avez pas mis métro, bien sûr, ça faisait trois. Boulot, métro, dodo. Irène qui nous dit « garçon est triste ». Et puis Coli qui nous dit « déprimé, perdu ». Mais non ! En plus, regardez, Coli, vous avez un superbe petit chien. Donc, il ne faut pas être déprimé et perdu avec un petit chien comme ça. Stardust, bonjour, bonjour, vous nous rejoignez. Nous changeons d'exercice. Allez, on y va. Alors, s'il vous plaît, n'oubliez pas de cliquer sur le petit like. Ça me ferait très, très, très plaisir. Merci beaucoup. C'est votre façon à vous de me dire merci, Vincent. Gaëtou qui nous dit « Je suis gentille et diligente ». Allez, the numbers of the day, as you probably know, if you are used to do the exercises with us. So, we have the numbers, and so I will have a dictation. Obviously, we'll start with some simple ones. So, this one will be with two digits, and I will only read it twice. You just need to write it in the comment section. So, we can go. And the first one is 73. 73. So now you can write it. Thank you. Alors, so far so good. Be careful, Hung, because you were a bit too generous. And in that case, it was 73, not 74. Hein. Hung, bonne aventure. Alors, I'm looking at the others. And so far so good. Yes, it's really good. So, 73, I remember, it will be 7 et 3. So, 7 et 0, 70. And then, of course, 71, 72, 73. Voilà, voilà. Alors, 73, très bien. We've got still a few people who are in the previous exercise. So, Fakel, maybe you should refresh your stream because it seems that you're not really synchronized with us. So, after that, number two. So, number two, in that case, obviously, we'll have three digits. So, I hope you're ready. Same thing here. I will read it only twice and then you just need to write it. On y va. 859 859 Alors, Victoria Jacques is a bit too generous today. Voilà, you corrected it right away. Correction automatique, je dis bravo, Victoria Jacques, bravo. So, 859, yeah, I'm looking at the things that are coming. So, it is really good, in fact. So, first, 100, it's 100. So, 800, it will be 800. Then, 50, 50. And 9, 9, 859, d'accord, 859, Faker, I don't really know why you put this beautiful Z, is it because you didn't catch the number, or maybe you are bored, we don't know, and that's the beauty about it. Allez, let's continue with the number 3. Number 3, you will have, in fact, 4 digits, so same thing here, I will read it twice, get ready, because I'm starting right now. 5072. 5072. Allez-y. Alors, attention, Hilary, yeah, probably you didn't hear the 5555, hein. On purpose, I didn't pronounce it like 5, because in most of the cases, people won't pronounce it like that, so 5000, 5000, it's 5000, d'accord, but you don't pronounce the k. So, 5000, and then 72, I can see that Cloudy Sky made the same mistake. Albuga is joining us, bonjour, bonjour, Albuga, you can participate, we're doing the numbers. Allez, Fiona is reminding you gently, and on, she's right, you should click on the like, remember. It pleases me a lot. Numéro 4. Numéro 4. And we will have 5 digits in that case. Be careful. 91032. 91032. Alors, Yeet Meat is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. You can participate. Now we're doing the numbers and then we will have other type of exercises after. Alors, Boomville Lover is the first one. After that, we can see that Cosmina is always, always there. Hein? Alors, 91 032. So you can see that 91 is 91. Be careful, Marianne. It was not 81, but it was 91. Ah, you heard 811. Be careful. Hein? In that case, it's really 91. 91. And after that, it was 32. So, 91 mille. Remember, mille is 1,000. 91 mille, and then 32. Voilà. Allez, because I know that Yossi was asking for that yesterday. And I want to please you, so Yossi was asking, what about 6 digits? And this is it, Yossi. Your dream came true. Allez, let's go for it. Same thing. I will repeat it only. I will read it twice. Let's go for it. 683 905. 683 905. Allez-y. Et c'est Fiona Adam, 683 905. Bravo, bravo Fiona. After that, it's a Boomville Lover. Albuga is right after. Mariam, she's good. So as you can see here, hein, so remember, 100, 100, 600. After that, 83, 83. 683, 1,000, it's 1,000. 683, 1,000. And then 905. Ice Cube is joining us. Bonjour, bonsoir Ice Cubes. I hope you're doing fine. Hein? Put the mask like I did, but then you might catch something like I did too. Really be careful when you go to the shop, because as you can see, Ice Cubes, and this is something that we'll have to define together, Gérard has a wife. I went to get a wife to Gérard, and we'll have to name her, but it will be after. Allez, merci beaucoup. Alice, remember, what do they think? It's a simple way to translate some sentences to see how you could translate them and how you could structure the sentences in French. So how could you say, I like to play with this ball? I like to play with this ball. How could you say that in French? Allez-y. Mariam, she's telling something that I was thinking about for a while, that yes, I look like Mickey Mouse with the two clocks. Well, it's nice, you know, and I could put my hands like that. Na 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 na. Alors, let's have a look at your things. So, I like to play. We agree that we discussed about this concept to like. Remember, the verb aimer by itself is to love. And then when we want to reduce the intensity of aimer, in that case, we will go for aimer bien. So aimer bien, technically, it's really to like. D'accord? If you say j'aime, it's I love. J'aime jouer, I love to play. J'aime bien jouer. In that case, you really want to well, to reduce the intensity. So j'aime bien jouer avec cette balle. Remember that you need to put a E in the end of balle, Emma, d'accord? And then I'm looking at the others. Yep, it's good. Remember that because balle is feminine, set should be written C-E-T-T-E. D'accord? C-E-T-T-E. And I try to put myself, maybe I should put my... Like that, I've got the ears, yeah. Well, you know, you get only animals now, hein? Allez, let's have a look at numéro 2. Numéro 2, and it's this one. Our radio show is very popular. How could you say that in French? Alors, Julia was the first one. Yeah, why not? In fact, you went for the Tout le monde aime nos podcasts. Well, let's agree on that. I mean, you are a young person, so this is the reason why you're using podcasts. Normally, we use émission de radio. This show, I mean, it's in most of the cases, we will use émission, whether it's for the radio or then if it's for the TV too. Une émission de télé, une émission de radio. Remember that it will be feminine, so it doesn't really impact. It's just for information. Notre émission de radio. Ice Cubes is going for the néologisme brutal. Notre radio show, Ice Cubes. Non, non, non. I'm pretty sure that in your language, which we know how much it did impact my language, pretty sure you don't say show. Probably you're using another word. Notre émission de radio est très populaire. Populaire, Paul is offering célèbre. Oui, I could, we could accept célèbre. It would be totally okay. Roman is offering célèbre too. No problem. Populaire, célèbre. It is totally acceptable. But don't put show because we don't use this show. Un show de radio, radio show, we don't use that. It's really une émission de radio, une émission de télé. D'accord? Allez, on continue. Numéro 3. Numéro 3. Can he come with me? Can he come with me? How could you say that in French? Alors, Bombville Lover is the first one, and yeah, nicely written, because you wanted to go with, like Hillary, by the way, with the inversion, so putting first the verb and after the subject, peut-il, which is extremely, extremely good. Personally, I went, because you could see that there were youngsters, for this informal way, like est-ce que, d'accord? Est-ce qu'il peut venir? Peut-il venir? Cloudy Sky goes for il peut venir, and then after that you raise the voice in the end, no problem. Be careful, Roman, because it's not pouvait-il. No, it must be peut, d'accord? You need to conjugate. Julia is using pourrait-il, which is totally okay. It's, yeah, it's more like this could, but it is totally acceptable. Mariam, yeah, be careful with the est-ce que. Look at your screen the way I wrote it. Peut-il venir? Rachid, it's good, yeah, yeah. So, no problem. So, we agree that it can be, est-ce qu'il peut venir avec moi? Peut-il venir avec moi? Il peut venir avec moi? And you raise the voice in the end. Or then, pourrait-il venir avec moi? Ou il pourrait venir avec moi? And you raise your voice in the end. Allez, on continue. Numéro 4. Numéro 4. I often use social networks. I often use social networks. How could you say that in French? Alors, Boomville Lover is in a great shape, hein, because now it's number one all the time. Alors, j'utilise, so yeah, in that case, we will go for the verb utiliser. I don't know what you can offer, but let's see. I wanted to go for utiliser, so after that, remember that normally you should put the adverb after, because the adverb is usually going after the verb. J'utilise souvent, and then yeah, I mean you write it quite properly. So réseau, if you've got the accent on your keyboard, don't forget to put accent aigu on the first réseau sociaux. It was really good. Well, you don't really have any problem on this one. In fact, it's quite good. I'm looking at your things and no, it's really good. Be careful, cloudy sky. J'utilise, hein. Your from the je needs to drop. Kirill, be careful, Kirill. Souvent should be after your verb. J'utilise souvent. D'accord, it's an adverb, it goes after the verb. Les réseaux sociaux, d'accord. Allez, let's have a look at numéro 5. Numéro 5, let me please remind you that if you arrived and you didn't yet click on the like, it would be really nice. Because you're 100 right now and I can see that I've got only 74 likes. Please, click on the like and then I would be so happy. Numéro 5. Numéro 5, this is the sentence. We hate waiting in line. We hate waiting in line. How could you say that in French? Allez-y. Alors, oui, faites attention, hein. So the idea of the exercise is of course also to introduce some expression. The expression that normally we use is faire la queue. Faire la queue is usually the expression in French that we use. So, nous détestons faire la queue. So the verb to hate, I mean, usually it's not a problem, and I can see that you go for détester, it's good. Tsan Hung went for on déteste, if you want, this is the informal thing. Normally we should go first for the nous, and after that, if the context allow it, then in that case you can go for the on, d'accord? So, and faire la queue, attendre dans la queue is offering kategik, not really. Faire la queue is really, really the thing that you should have. Paula, Paula, we agree that we're trying to not to go too deep in the level of languages. Of course you can say that, and you're showing your tongue. it's possible, but still, this is not what you would say to everybody, I guess. Voilà, numéro 6. Numéro 6. Will my friends see me too? Will my friends see me too? Phil, faire un fil? Non, Mariam. Non, it's not possible in that case. It's really faire la queue. Alors, Sherilyn, it's the first one. Mes amis me verront-ils aussi? Magnifique phrase. Hein? Same thing here. You are going for the most beautiful form that we could get, in fact. So you start with your subject, mes amis, and then verront-ils. You repeat the subject, which is really, really good. Personally, I went because I saw that it was a young person. So, once again, for the est-ce que, hein, est-ce que mes amis me verront aussi? The important thing too is to remember that in that case, the verb is voir. And definitely, you should put the voir in the real future, to this future simple. Remember, future simple voir, the root will be ver, V-E-R-R. And after that, you will put your endings. Je verrai, A-I. Tu verras, A-S. Il, elle verra, A. Nous verrons, O-N-S, vous verrez, E-Z, ils, elles verront, O-N-T, so this is the form that we wanted to have. So, est-ce que mes amis me verront aussi? Mes amis me verront-ils aussi? Was probably the best option, in fact, but this might not be the one that you will use in a daily conversation. So in most of the cases, we will go for this est-ce que form. D'accord? Allez, on continue. Numéro 7. Numéro 7, and this is the thing, vacations. It's really difficult. Vacations, it's really difficult. And I don't know who. Albuga, once more. For you, it's Chopin. Alors, Albuga is motivated by the Chopin music. Alors, oui, très bien. Les vacances, hein, les vacances, we should start with this definite pronoun. I mean, it would be better. And after that, c'est vraiment difficile. Keep in mind that when we go for the c'est form, it means that even if you're talking about something that is feminine or talking about something that is plural, like in that case, the structure in itself with c'est will impact the adjective. It means that the adjective will stay in the masculine singular form. This is the concept. So in that case, we're talking about des vacances, but still, as you can see, your difficile is definitely not in the plural form because it is introduced by c'est. This is the point, it's extremely important. Remember, you're eating something, it can be an ice cream. An ice cream, une glace, it's feminine, but still you will say, c'est bon, c'est bon. You will keep the masculine because it's introduced with the c'est. Allez, let's continue, numéro 8. Numéro 8, I love riding my bike while listening to music. I love riding my bike while listening to music. How could you say that in French? Allez-y. So don't forget that in few minutes, we've got these two little characters. Yesterday, we baptized the man, Monsieur, and the name, it was suggested by Victoria Jacques, which was extremely, extremely good. So now we know that this Monsieur is called Gérard. In few minutes, we will, and I'm trying to put my... we'll try to name his wife that I went to the shop. I risked my life to go to the shop to buy this little lady. And it's his wife, and we'll have to find the name of the wife of Gérard. Madame, but not yet. Allez, let's have a look at what you're offering. So, in that case, I love, as I told you, it can be aimé. I wanted also to put the other option, adoré. Adoré can be really to love in a strong manner. Anyways, it goes the same way. So it means that the verb that will come right after should definitely be in the infinitive. Faire du vélo is the expression. So I guess it's okay for you. Voilà. After that, we need to start to go with this gérondif structure. So gérondif, we will introduce that with en, and after that we will put the participe présent écoutant. If you don't know how to construct the gérondif or then this participe présent, check my videos, they are extremely detailed, and you will understand how it goes. En écoutant, it's while listening, d'accord? And then de la musique would be the good option. Écouter de la musique, ouais, d'accord. I think that. Remember, Kirill, la musique, I-Q-U-E, d'accord? J'aime faire du vélo en écoutant de la musique. Hein? So remember this, en écoutant, it's to express two actions that happen simultaneously, so at the same time. Numéro 9. Numéro 9, and she's looking at you. She's looking at you because she wants to be named soon. This is our first trip this year. This is our first trip this year. How could you say that in French? Alors, Ice Cube is asking, est-ce que tu vas acheter les enfants de Gérard aussi? Well, you don't know, because I was extremely, extremely productive in the shop. Trust me, I didn't only live with two persons. Non, 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 je ne suis pas comme ça. Alors, regardons. Sherilyn was the first one, c'est notre premier voyage cette année. Julia aussi, be careful, it should be notre. Hein? So we agree that voyage is masculine, so Cosmina, your adjective should be premier. Hein? Don't go for première, hein, because it's un voyage, c'est notre premier masculin voyage cette année. Cette année, well, année is a feminine word, so set should be written C-E-T-T-E, the feminine form of this demonstrative. So, c'est notre premier masculin voyage cette année. Très bien, Kirill, be careful, it's really cette année. You want to emphasize on the duration of the thing. D'accord? Allez, the last one for this exercise, and it's this one. Women are in the majority. Women are in the majority. How could you say that in French? Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. Thank you. Alors, je regarde Cosmina is the first one. Les femmes sont en majorité, oui. Alors, personally, I went for the adjective majoritaire because I just wanted to show you that we can use it. Ouais, Sherilyn went in the same direction. Let me check. Boom, V-lover. Dans la majorité, really good too. Hein? It's an option, no problem. So, les femmes sont dans la majorité. Les femmes sont majoritaires. Albuga went for dans la majorité. En majorité, it depends. After that, I'm expecting something, but it could be possible too. Looking at the others, les femmes sont... Be careful, Emma, you don't say les femmes sont majorité. You should put after your son an adjective, so majoritaire, d'accord? And as you can see, this is the reason why you have the S at the end of majoritaire, hein? Because it is directly connected to femme. Majoritaire, the adjective in itself, it doesn't change if it's masculine or feminine. It will end with E no matter what. But if you put the plural, and in that case we have the plural, you need to put S in the end. D'accord, très bien. YZ, bonjour professeur, bonjour YZ. J'espère que vous allez bien. So you can join now and we'll do the next exercise. Merci beaucoup. Mariam, be careful. Des femmes, well, could be discussed. We should go for les femmes, d'accord? But remember to put S at the end of femme, hein, Mariam, because it definitely needs to be there. You've got the plural form now. You are 116 person. It is nice. I like that. It is really good, but still I've got only 91 likes. There is something wrong, messieurs, mesdames. There is something wrong, messieurs, mesdames. Click on the like and please, please, try to give me at least 100 likes for this lesson. It would be really, really nice. Merci. Alors voilà. Alors voilà. Alors voilà. Remember the story. Yesterday, I introduced this little person here, the red guy, avec la barbe. And I was asking you what name we could give him. I mean, and we decided to find Gérard. Victoria Jacques was the genius to offer us Gérard. So now, I went to the shop to get, whoop, whoop, I don't see... His wife, right there. Coucou. C'est sa femme. C'est la femme de Gérard. So it's his wife. But then we don't have a name for the wife of Gérard. So now it's your turn. Please, please, please. À votre avis, comment pourrait s'appeler la femme de notre lutin, Gérard? S'il vous plaît, faites-moi des propositions. Merci. Thank you. And that's it. It was simple. In fact, I was looking at your thing. So first, I would like to thank, really from the bottom of my heart, Kate Geek, who is offering me a great fast food meal. Thank you very much. It is really, really nice. But then I would like to say to Paul Joshua, that I think that the wife of Gérard, I think that you found her name, because her name might be, and it was really good, Colette. I think it's really fun, Gérard et Colette. So let's say hello to Colette. Colette is the wife of Gérard. Merci beaucoup, Paul Joshua. It was really, really great. So this is the name officially of our couple. It's Gérard, and Colette is wife. And of course, we'll see that behind me. We've got other characters, and you will see that it will last for a while. That's the idea of this week. Allez, à vous la parole. Quelle est la chose la plus gentille que quelqu'un vous ait jamais dite? Quelle est la chose la plus gentille que quelqu'un vous ait jamais dite? S'il vous plaît, une petite minute, écrivez-moi une phrase. Alors, c'est Doré, Nilianiki, oh, on lui a dit, t'es adorable. Et ça, ça fait plaisir. Cause it's here, on lui a dit, je t'aime, mon pote. Ça aussi, c'est formidable. C'est formidable, on voudrait l'entendre tous les jours. Emma, on lui a dit, tu es très gentille. D'accord? Et c'est vrai, Emma. Hein? It's not possible to get fed up with this nice thing. Hillary qui nous dit, on lui a dit, je t'aime, oui. Stardust, on lui a dit, tu as un cœur d'or. Ça, c'est sympathique, ça, c'est incroyable. Victoria Jacques, quand Yasmine a dit que j'étais une vraie reine, j'apprécie toujours ça. Est-ce que vous avez votre couronne, Victoria? Victoria Jacques dort avec sa couronne, peut-être. Canita, je préfère te connaître heureux sans moi. Je suis triste, hein? Alors, attendez, sans... Canita, I'm lost. Je préfère te connaître heureux sans moi que triste avec moi. Ouais. It's nice, but with a little bit of distance, I guess. D'accord. Alors, Paula, je vous en prie, je trouve cette expression trop gentille. Oui. Attendez, et c'est beau de l'écouter. Je vous en prie, it's really nice. Hein. Je vous en prie. Surtout quand vous utilisez le « vous », hein. When you use the « vous », it's even more sweet. Julia, je touche cette expression « fast », mais elle n'a pas encore arrivé. Ah, vous attendez la phrase, Julia. Mais il faut être patiente. Roman, quand je joue, que je joue beaucoup de beau volleyball. Ah, d'accord, que vous jouez bien au volleyball. Très bien. Bon, oui, ça, c'est chouette. Baveshi, je voudrais devenir comme vous. Oh, ben, ça, c'est formidable. Yossi, nous vous remercions. Pour tout, ouais, ça c'est toujours, ça fait plaisir. Ça fait toujours plaisir. Paul, vous êtes un homme très gentil. Eh oui, ça c'est bien aussi. Fiona Adams, je t'aime beaucoup. Bickert, tu es magnifique. Oh, j'imagine, j'espère, Bickert, que c'est vos enfants ou votre mari qui vous a dit ça, ce serait formidable. Mais les enfants, c'est rare hein, quand ils disent ça. Ensuite, Kate Geek, vous êtes une femme très gentille. Ça, c'est formidable. Alors, Yasmine qui dit que Victoria Jacques est la reine. Oui, on devrait la voir avec sa couronne, je pense. Baveshi, je vous en prie. C'est Monta que j'ai un beau sourire. Ah bah oui, ça, c'est formidable. Ice Cubes, je suis très contente de connaître une belle personne comme vous. Ah oui, ça, c'est bien. Kirill, vous avez l'air jaune. Kirill, est-ce que c'est l'air jaune, la couleur, ou est-ce que c'est l'air jeune, peut-être? Oui, Kirill a enlevé sa phrase. Chériline, c'est très noble de ta part. Tu ferais une personne, une très bonne superviseure. Compatissante. Très bien, Chériline. Huang, vous êtes le meilleur prof. Ah ben ça fait toujours plaisir. Et puis Kirill qui a corrigé, you've been correcting, it's nice. Vous avez l'air jeune et non pas jaune, because it would be a bit strange. Hein. Merci beaucoup. Allez, c'est la dictée, the dictation of the day. So we'll have four sentences that you will have to write. Remember, I will read them two times. Let me try to scroll down because we've been doing quite many things so far. Voilà. Okay, so I will read them two times. Remember, as I say, when I will change now the slide, you will see the translation. I mean, I put the translation for the beginner and intermediate, so you can see the translation. If you just want to work on the dictation aspect, don't look at the translation. Still, it's there, though, so just be aware. On y va. Première phrase. J'y pense et puis j'oublie. J'y pense et puis j'oublie. Write the sentence, please. Alors, I am looking at your thing, so it's starts to arrive, so it's quite good, in fact. So in that case, the first thing that was important was the verb penser, so penser, regular verb, so it's not really tricky, in fact, to conjugate. Je pense, P-E-N-S-E. Remember that penser à quelque chose, à quelqu'un, and in that case, we will use, in fact, the pronoun Y, when it's for a thing. J'y pense. D'accord? The pronoun should definitely come before the verb. J'y pense. Et puis, well, this is not tricky. I mean, I'm looking at your forms and right now it's quite good. Be careful because it's here. You've been forgetting the I on puis. And the last thing. So this is the important thing. Remember, oublier, a regular verb from the first group. But still, all these verbs in yer, when you will conjugate them, you write it like you can see on your screen. So O-U-B-L-I-E. I mean, the rule is respected. We conjugate it the way it should be conjugated for the regular verbs of the first group. But final E is totally mute, so you pronounce j'oublie. But still, the E must be there. J'y pense et puis j'oublie. And it's a song, by the way. Well, it was a long, long time ago. I think it was Claude François. J'y pense et puis j'oublie. Let's have a look at numéro 2. Numéro 2, same thing here. Don't look at the translation if you don't need it. I am reading the sentence two times. Elles ne lui en ont jamais parlé. Elles ne lui en ont jamais parlé. Write the sentence. Alors, Zeynep Essen is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. You can participate the lesson. Everything is going fine. Marlène Go, bonjour. You still have few minutes, 9 minutes to go. Alors, let's have a look because this one was a bit tricky. Yes. Look, alors. Well, the idea was what? The idea was first to use, in fact, the verb parler. In the passé composé form. Elles ont parlé. D'accord. After that, of course, I wanted to introduce the negative form with jamais. Elles ne ont jamais parlé. Normally, should be put away and then put the apostrophe. But now, because of course you know that I want to put some pronouns, this is the tricky thing. So, I'm putting two pronouns. I'm putting en and I'm putting lui. Elle ne lui en ont jamais parlé. This is the main difficulty of French language. When you start to put some, well, pronouns for the compound tenses and you start to put a negative form, it is extremely, extremely challenging to know exactly where to put the elements. So remember, it was the verb parler, passé composé form, negative form ne jamais, with two pronouns before your helping verb avoir. D'accord? Don't hate me. I'm just doing my job. It's for you. Allez, let's have a look at numéro 3. Numéro 3, here it comes. Same thing here. You don't need to look at the translation if you just want to focus on the dictation. Vous ne lui en donnerez plus. Vous ne lui en donnerez plus. Allez-y. Alors, Cosmina Belouise, the first one, with a perfect sentence, yes. Same thing here, so the verb is donner. Obviously, I wanted to also play now with another tense. In that case, it's the futur simple, vous donnerez. As you know, let's try to squeeze some negative form. So, vous ne donnerez plus. And then, obviously, because I want to play with the pronouns, I'm putting one more time two pronouns, lui and en. Vous ne lui en donnerez plus. So far, so good. I mean, some of you were a bit struggling with the thing, but then generally it's quite good. Remember to work on the futur simple if you still have some difficulties or if you're not really sure. Canita Show, be careful. It was not the present, d'accord? But it was really, really the futur simple in that case. I'm looking at the others and, well, Donnerai, because it's here, be careful. You've been starting to change the rule of the conjugaison, don't drop the E in donnerai. Non, 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 non. Allez, let's have a look at numéro 4. Same thing here, don't look at the translation if you only want to work on the the dictation. Je ne vais pas les lui donner. Je ne vais pas les lui donner. So write the sentence, please. Alors, Julia is the first one, and the sentence is perfectly written. Je ne vais pas, so in that case, I wanted to go to with, once again, the verb donner, but then in the future proche form, aller, conjugated in the present form with the infinitive. So, je vais donner. After that, obviously, I'm putting some negative form to make it a bit more difficult. Je ne vais pas donner. D'accord? Ah, you could see that. Cosmina, I told you, I'm starting to be sick now. So it's possible. Everything is possible now. So je ne vais pas donner. And obviously, I wanted once again to put pronouns. Les and lui. So je ne vais pas les lui donner. D'accord? And the translation, Fiona Adams is obviously right. It's not there. But, you know, this is when you realize that I am just a bit sick. And it's almost the end. So I'm okay. I am okay now. My conscience is totally clear. Allez, merci. Et voilà, I think it was a sign, and it was a sign to just tell me that Vincent, you need to stop, you need to rest, so I will see, I hope that tomorrow I will be up to the challenge, and if I am, and I think I will, then we'll see tomorrow if you want. Remember that we have now Gérard and then Colette. Gérard and Colette will discover their life at one point, because we need to somehow discover together the story of their lives, and probably we'll start to meet other persons from their family. It will be quite interesting, I guess, and it will be your story. So let's see what you will come up with. Merci beaucoup. Au revoir. Let's see you tomorrow if you want.
Yksin, parvekkeen kaiteella. Alla maailma, jonne et tahdo palata. Suurin ongelma on, ettei ole ongelmaa. Tarpeeksi soha, joka allen sinut musertaa.
lisen reunan ja asetu troikkumaanni. Et ainoa mitä tehdä pitää, on pitää kiinni. Et ainoa mitä tehdä pitää, on pitää kiinni.